Hello students, a very happy and cheerful morning to all of you. I hope you all are fine and taking good care of your health. So students, in your subject grammar, we were doing chapter 13, pronouns. So I hope you have understood till what we have studied in our previous video lessons. Now come on children, take out your textbooks and let us move towards our next exercise. So children, in our last video lesson, we had completed till exercise E. And I have given you homework to complete the remaining numbers like I have done till 1st to 5 and rest for your homework. I hope you have completed. Now moving further with our exercise F. Let us see what is there. Fill in the blanks with correct form of personal pronouns. Now, do you remember what we studied of personal pronouns? What we studied about personal pronouns? I told you to remember from the word person itself. Letter C. Let us revise. Personal pronouns are pronouns used in place of people, animals and things. So, from the word person, you can come to know that personal pronouns kisko replace karte hain? Used in place of people, animal and things. Now exercise F. First, please come here. Dash want to talk to you. You have to use personal pronoun. Please come here. Dash want to talk to you. I want to talk to you. What will I say you? Please come here. I want to talk to you. Okay. So here you will write I. I is a person. That means it is a personal pronoun. Second, come and tell dash what happened. If I am telling you, come and tell dash what happened. So what will come in this space? Come and tell me what happened. Come and tell me what happened. Okay. Then, my mother told dash about my great grandfather. My mother told dash. My mother told me about my great grandfather. Okay children, so I hope you are getting that how we have to complete this exercise using personal pronoun. Very simple. Fourth, Rita is my best friend. And dash is absent today. Now in the place of Rita, what will you use? Rita is the name of a girl. Rita is my best friend and she is absent today. Okay? I'll tell you five and five you'll do by yourself. Fifth, see. Now what is the fifth sentence? I have a question for each one of dash. I have a question for each one of you. I have a question for each one of you. So here what you will write? Y-O-U. You. So now 6 to 10 will be your homework. Okay. 5 I told you and 5 you will try by yourself. So from 6 to 10 will be your homework. Okay. Now moving further with our next topic. Let us see this table. What is this table about? Singular and plural pronouns. Which pronouns? You already know singular and plural. You know the meaning. Now you have to learn about singular and plural pronouns. Just like nouns, pronouns can be singular or plural. We all have studied in the previous chapters that nouns have singular form, plural form. So just like nouns, pronouns also have, pronouns can also be singular or plural. Now, singular pronoun. Which are singular pronoun? See, I, me, she, her, him, it. They are singular pronouns. Then, which are plural pronouns? We, us, you, they, them. Okay, when I'm only talking about one person, like I, so I is singular. She, I'm talking about you. She is a good girl, singular. You are intelligent, only one person, singular. In the same way, what are the example of plural pronouns? We are going to park today. We means I and my friends. Okay, so we is plural. Us, mother scolded us, again plural. You is in singular also and in plural also. They and them. Okay, now these were the examples. Now genders. Now what are genders? Just like nouns, pronouns too have genders. Just like nouns, pronouns too have genders. See, masculine, feminine, common, neuter. You all know these four genders. Masculine means male, female means feminine means female. Common means which can be used for both male and female. Neuter means which do not have any gender. So, just like you know the gender, pronouns also have gender. See, for masculine pronoun, we use he is going, teacher scolded or teacher appreciated him. So, that is used for masculine. She and her is used for feminine. She is a smart girl. Okay. Then, mother appreciated her. So, her and she are pronouns and they come in the category of feminine pronouns. Then, common gender. I, we, me. This is not particular male or female. We use we for boys also can say that we are going to school. Girls also can say. I is, can be said by boy also and girl also. Me also is a common. Us also and you also. And in the place of non-living thing like any object, and it comes in the category of neuter gender, which do not have any gender. So children, I hope you have understood this table, that pronouns can be singular and plural and pronouns have gender. Now based on this, we will solve an exercise in our next video lesson. So, till then, you can understand this table so that it will be easy for you to solve the exercise. Now, children, we'll meet in our next video lesson. Till then, take care, keep smiling, God bless you.